We basically we have already covered the finite automata. The finite automata, what we have already taught, it basically acceptor or rejector, so that you give input a string, say 0 1 1 0, or if the 0 1 1 is the alphabet, or if you give the alphabet is AB, then you can give the AAA AAB like this. Then this is the sentence. What is sentence? It consists of a terminal, and the sentence is a part of a language. If the sentence you put to a machine, the machine ultimately ends at accept state or reject state. So this is a kind of a decision problems. In the last lecture 11, I have told the computer science, though it is easy, it looks that decision problem is one of the easiest problem, but it is not. Decision problem is one of the toughest problem. So after whether the language, whether the particular string is a part of a language, we can only test it by putting to a machine. Say if it's a regular language like a to the power n b, or a b to the power n, or a to the power m b to the power n. What is a to the power m b to the power n? Like a m number of repetition, b n number of repetition, no relation between m and n. Whenever I put string to a finite state machine, designed finite state machine, it accepts. But whenever we try with a to the power n and b to the power n to a finite state machine, we cannot design a finite state machine which can compare and count the values of a and values of b. So we require then the stack, infinite stack for counting. So that is it. That is the, here the machine is either accept or reject, not in the beginning, at the end of the string. Okay, but at the end of the string. But there are several kinds of machines that we require, that we need the result, not accept. We are not bothered about exception or rejection. We are, every state transition, we want to get result from the machine, any output. It is not accept or reject. If we accept, we want say A or B or 0 and 1. That's a separate alphabet. What is input string is separate alphabet. Sigma and output is a separate alphabet. I want that output. It is very useful. There are two kinds of machine like this. One is Mealy machine and one is Moore machine. It is a six tuple. It is, just see this. This is a Mealy machine and Moore machine. This is a six tuple. Which one tuple is missing here? That is in your finite state machine. That is F. So F is set of accepting state. So we are not interested whether it goes to accept state or reject state. Rather, we are interested in transition. So we have two delta function. One delta function for transition, and another is, this is the sigma is the input alphabet and O is the finite set of symbols output alphabet. So they are distinct, different, and the delta is the transition function. So it goes from state to state, and X is the output. Here delta is the output input transition function. X is the output transition function. It maps to any symbol. And Q0 is the initial state. So that is it. So what is missing here? We are missing here, we are not saying whether the string is accepted or rejected, so that we do not have any if here. So that is missing. But two extra things we have come. That is, one thing is the output alphabet other than input, and another is the X is the output transition function. So these are the Mealy machine, and it gives the output with every transition. Let's have some diagram. Yeah, this is the Mealy machine. So every state, say here, this is, don't confuse, this first one is the input alphabet, and second zero, that is from this zero, from output alphabet. So every transition, we have some output, and there is no concept of accept or reject. So anytime it transit, every transition it gives output. This is Mealy machine. Another kind of machine is a Moore machine. Moore machine gives output not per transition, it gives the output per state. Same here also, six tuple, Here also Q0 initial stage and output, and it is the no, and it is here lambda is the output function. Here convention in MIDI we have used O, another thing we have used, you can use it here lambda. It is nothing but a convention. In some books you might see it different, but you have to remember there is no acceptance state here, and you get output at the state itself. This way a Moore machine is much more stable, because at the transition is there is some the glitch that it can change quickly state. So Moore machine is more stable. Moore machine require more number of states, and you can convert a Billy machine to Moore machine. We'll show it in subsequent classes. And Moore machine to Billy machine, both is there, and number of states are Moore machine are generally higher. So this is the Moore machine. This is another way. This is, you see, the output comes with the state, not at the transition. So much better. Here also six tuple. These are the distinction. Milli machine output depends upon present state and the present input. This is the, and output depends only upon present state. So this is say AND gate, and this is only a AND gate is only one input present state. Generally it has fewer states than Moore machine, that I have told. More state, Moore machine is stable. Output changes at the clock edges. Yes, input change, cost change on the output as soon as logic is done. So it takes time, it is slower, bit slower. Milli machine react faster, that's true. And Moore machine, more logic is needed to decode the output since it is more circuit delays. Yeah, it is bit slower, but it is stable. Okay, so this is the distinction between Milli machine and Moore machine. And we'll be taught conversion of Moore machine and Milli machine and Milli machine to Moore machine. These machines are available, like counter is a Moore machine. There are lots of, lots of machines are available. You can see it. Thank you for listening. Thank you for viewing.